Hello, I'm Melanie Stambaugh, and I'm proud to serve the 25th District in the House of Representatives. I continue to receive calls and emails from concerned educators and community members regarding the education system in our state. This legislative session has been labeled the education session, and over the past several months, I've met with numerous education advocacy groups, our educators, students, and administrative teams to discuss not only the immediate needs for our education system, but the larger vision of what quality education looks like for our students. Education is the backbone of our communities and our economy. It provides the opportunity for students to become successful and accomplish their goals regardless of their background or their economic status. To the educators watching, thank you. Your work day in and day out with our young leaders, teaching, assisting, and challenging our students to reach greater heights, it's truly priceless. I know how hard you work, and I continue to push for changes in the legislature that better reflect the values of your work and the value of all of our educational staff in the schools. I would like to address a few of the concerns I have heard from our educators around the state. First, the cost of living adjustment. Many educators have reached out to me and shared their frustrations that COLAs have been repeatedly suspended prior to my time in office. I am proud to share that the cost of living adjustments have been included in both the House and the Senate proposed budgets. This is a good first step to fund COLAs that voters approved and our educators deserve. Second is teacher compensation. As a member of the House Education Committee, I recently received a report from the Compensation Technical Work Group on teacher wages. This group conducted a wage comparison analysis and presented the findings for the legislature to use in reforming the current education compensation model. The problems raised by the work group match the concerns that I have heard from our newest teachers in the classroom, whose compensation is inadequate to pay off high student debt and to live on. The recommendations from the work group are currently being used in the compensation negotiations and could result in a 30% increase in base pay for our first-year educators. Being a new legislator, I am not involved in the negotiation process yet, but I will continue to advocate for fair compensation for our educators that encourages them to teach in all areas across our state, brings in new educators into the profession, and accurately reflects the time and energy that is dedicated in the classroom. Third is testing. There needs to be greater balance in the quality and the quantity of student testing that occurs in our classroom. Educators, I hear your frustration that teaching time is being redirected and condensed to accommodate an increasing focus on tests and the numerous testing days. Students, I hear your frustration too, and your exhaustion from having to take test after test after test. The House recently passed House Bill 2214 off the floor, which aims to reduce the amount of testing while maintaining high standards and providing additional support for students to meet graduation requirements. The bill will help reduce remedial education in college and will offer more hands-on learning options that truly align with our state's college and career readiness goals. An online post from an educator said it best. We need to raise the bar while adding additional cushion for our students and educators, as many changes are taking place in our education system. Fourth is reduction in classroom size. This is being addressed this session. Kindergarten through third grade classes will see the first reductions in their class size numbers. This is by no means the final step. Work with local districts to address overcrowding is currently underway. Finally, the federal No Child Left Behind Act has created many holes in our education system and left state legislatures across the country burdened with the task of passing policies to elicit the waiver approval from the United States Department of Education. And the waiver system is simply a band-aid over the true problems in federal law. I believe that it's important we address the larger issues in education. We need to better define the federal role and the state's role in education, while making strides towards greater local control. I was recently in Washington, D.C., working with our federal representatives, senators, and the Department of Education to begin finding solutions to these underlying problems. In our state, we have school districts with as few as 5 students to as many as 50,000 students. The policies we implement as a legislature must be flexible, equitable, and sustainable. The legislature is moving forward with a balanced approach, making headway in compensation reform and implementing class size reductions, all while respecting the hard-earned dollars that our taxpayers pay to this state. We are seeing over $3.2 billion in increased revenue for the 2015-2017 biennium, and proposed budgets this session put forward a record amount of revenue into education funding. I was sworn into office in January and have been working hard to build relationships with educators, administrators, students, and legislators here in Olympia who are passionate and committed to understanding the needs of our education system and making the necessary changes. There is much to do, not only during this education session, but in the months and years to come. I ask that you continue to contact me with your concerns, and I would like to extend an invitation to meet in district, to talk over the phone, and for educators, you to invite me to visit your school or classroom. The success of our students, the success of our educators, and the success of our legislature fulfilling its paramount duty of providing a quality education for our students depends on all of us working together. I look forward to continuing to work with you to improve education here in the state of Washington. Thank you.